I am one with the shadow. Huh? Bitch.
What is up, guys? It's your boy Joda with Casual Panic, and today we're talking about Near Replicant version 1.22474487139. Now, as some of you may already know, I'm a huge Near Automata fan, and that was the first game in the Near series that I had ever played. Near Replicant, which originally came out in 2010, takes place thousands of years before Near Automata. And though the games don't link directly, they do indirectly take place in the same world. Having played Near Automata first, there are a lot of things in Near Replicant that I'm noticing that tie these two games together that people like myself who played Near Automata first are having a really fun time finding in Near Replicant. I've played Near Replicant now for about 12 hours over the last week. Even though I'm still relatively toward the beginning of the story, I can tell that there are some dominoes in motion that are about to really kick the story off. Now, I want to keep this relatively spoiler-free, so I want to talk about some of the things that I really like and things I don't like about Near Replicant so far. Starting off with something that I love about this game is the combat. Near Automata set the bar very high when it comes to action combat games. It was fast-paced, but it was still pretty skill-based as well, because you had to be dodging attacks while also trying to get your own attacks off. Near Replicant has its own version of that combat system, where it also adds a parry mechanic, as well as the dodge mechanic being a little less powerful, but also lets you get behind your opponent and continue your combo. The magic system is also great. You get a bunch of really powerful spells, as well as the Dark Blast, which is kind of like your Gatling gun from Near Automata. Now let's move on to one thing that I don't like as much about Near Replicant. When it comes to these missions, a lot of them are very generic fetch missions. They have you run from point A to point B, back to point A, to point C, back to point A, and after a while it can kind of get monotonous and boring. Now this does serve a purpose, as when it gets to the really big moments in the game, I think it enhances those moments, seeing as you're very, very bored with these monotonous missions, and then you get hit with this epic moment where you have a huge boss battle or a really awesome story point. Having the lows along with the highs makes the highs that much better. It's kind of like if you listen to an album of music and every single song was a banger, really none of them would be bangers. You gotta have some really slow songs in there or some less interesting ones to make those really good ones even better. Now back to something that I love about Near Replicant is the characters. So far, the characters have been the shining star in this game and this story. First, you have our protagonist, who is pretty much your generic hero-type character, except you can feel his motivations for saving his sister Yona. And something else I've noticed about the protagonist is that he changes over the course of the game. People who have already played this game will know that he changes in a big way about halfway through the story. But I think what's more interesting is the less subtle change that he has is the anger and resentment he has for the Shades, which are the main enemies in the game. It reminds me a lot of the way that 9S and Near Automata felt toward the machines. Both of them have these one-track minds where they just want to kill the enemy as quickly and efficiently as possible, with zero mercy. The next character we have to talk about is Grimoire Vice, who, whenever he speaks, I just can't get Gaara's voice out of my head from Naruto. But anyway, Grimoire Vice, who is equally the most serious and funniest character in the game. As you may have seen in the intro to this video, there are some lines where you wouldn't expect him to say these words, but they come out of this book's mouth, and you just can't help but laugh. And then finally, my favorite character and waifu forever, Kaine. The woman with a mouth that would make any sailor jealous, and an outfit that would make every Karen shit their pants. I think we can all agree that Kaine is probably one of the most well-written characters who is just entertaining, but also admirable. She's the kind of person who isn't afraid to tell you what's on her mind, and she is not going to censor herself. The best is when you're in the middle of a boss fight, and then she ends up saying something like,
"I'm gonna pull out your teeth and cram them up your ass!"
And lastly, I wanted to talk about Devola and Popola, who are both important characters in Near Automata and in Near Replicant. In Near Automata, they're always talking about how they did something bad and they're trying to atone for those sins. So for me playing Near Automata first, I have a couple big questions in my head. One, what is it that they did that made them feel this way? And two, how did they survive this long? Because I'm pretty sure Near Automata takes place thousands of years after Near Replicant. It's these pieces of the story that I think makes these games so powerful. And also, in no matter which order you play them, I think that the stories hold their own, and still have surprises sprinkled out throughout the story. The last surprise in this story that I'm expecting to happen is the explanation of how our main protagonist and Yona, in the beginning of the game, the very beginning of the game, survived or were reincarnated into the versions that we see 1400 years later. This all happens in the beginning of Nier Replicant, and I believe is going to be explained toward the end of the game. I just haven't gotten to that point yet. So yeah, I'm gonna leave it off there. If you guys haven't been playing the game, I highly recommend you check it out, both Nier Automata and Nier Replicant. If you guys know of any more non-spoiler connections between Nier Automata and Nier Replicant, please leave a comment down below. I'd be really interested to know what you guys have found. And if you guys like this video, as always, please like, subscribe, and comment down below on what you guys want us to do next. We've been trying our hand out at some really short clips of us playing games and trying to make them a little funny, so go ahead and check those out. I know we have one about Valorant that I made a couple days ago. I'll leave a link to that one after this video is over. But anyway, I'm gonna leave it there. Thank you guys for watching. I've been Joda, and I will see you in the next one.